brought up Russia.
We know that. We know that from our hometown.
The reason that I brought up Russia is because contextually, that's when the president started banging on leaks, because he didn't like that information was coming out about it. He didn't like the implications of it politically. So he wanted to focus on the leaks instead of the substance. And I'm saying journalistically, that is a concern. Politically,
okay, well,
I get why you want a police message within your house. In your house,
I didn't study that like Quincy. I wasn't a coroner studying that. Remember the Jack Klugman show?
He was a medical examiner, not a coroner, but continue.
Yeah, all right, well, whatever. It was medical examiner. I wasn't studying it back then, okay? That's a narrative that I think is a false narrative, and I'm going to push back for the president.
What is the false narrative?
The false narrative is, he doesn't like the leaks coming out on Russia, so he's pushing back.
It's 100% true.
That's not, okay, but that isn't true.
He's it's 100% true. You just said it's
Russia,
true. You just said he doesn't like
saying,
those leaks. Those are part of the leaks he doesn't like.
Scandals Incorporated, another fake scandal that we're going to manufacture.
There's nothing fake about the Russia investigation. There's nothing fake about the emails
the
that Don Jr.
Chris,
put out of Russians trying to work them over.
Forget about the hacking and all the other stuff. We're going to get into the hacking later. I'm talking about the collusion of the campaign with the Russians and the Russian government. That's the specific thing that I'm talking about, which you and I both know they can't find any evidence of anywhere. Now, you want to talk about the fact that the Russians could have possibly hacked into the system and done something.
Not possibly.
Hillary Clinton
they did.
Emails or something like that. We can debate that later, okay?
I'm saying that's where the leak stuff started with the president.
I'll stay on side with the president, and I said this to Tapper, Jake Tapper, over the weekend.
Mm-hmm.
If the Russians really hacked that thing, they could possibly be clever enough not to leave any footprints. So the president is skeptical. You know, well, we talked last night at dinner. I hope he's not mad at me for relaying this on TV, but I'm going to relay it. He said that he thought for sure that after reading all this stuff as an outsider, that there were actually weapons of mass destruction in Iraq. He said that last night. And then he said there obviously weren't weapons of mass destruction in Iraq, so he has his guard up. As it relates to some of the things that people say definitively and declaratively. The CIA director at that time said that the information related to the weapons of mass destruction was a quote-unquote slam dunk. I'm not going to bring the guy's name up because he's a terrific guy and he made a mistake. Big deal. The point is, when you say that we know definitively, or Jake Tapper says that he knows definitively, thank God we have President Donald J. Trump in the room that's going to have a little bit of a skepticism and a cautious eye on this stuff. Protect the American people, and particularly American servicemen.
Except you're leaving one part out, Anthony. You're leaving out that the reason Jake Tapper or any journalist talks about this is because the director of National Intelligence, the head of CIA, the guys the president put in, say it.
Sorry, before you say all that, I'm trying to give your viewers insight into the president's personality, okay? The president says all the time, there is one country in the world that can take our country out in 35 minutes. I don't know if they have 8,700 nukes, whatever the numbers are, it's a big number. It's incumbent upon us, and it's incumbent upon them, whatever you think of them, that we try to get along with each other. Okay? Go ahead. Go to the next question. Go ahead.
Look, it's just that contextually, that's why I brought it up. It's not that we have some untoward fascination with an investigation. We do it because it threatens the foundation of the democracy. You know that. You know it matters. The president
I know it matters.
The president should know that questioning.
Conway has said it, and I'll say
what I'm saying, questioning his own intel chiefs is just an odd strategy for a president.
If he gets definitive smoking gun proof, he will take action. He's looking at these sanctions right now. He may decide to veto the sanctions and
Why?
Be tougher on the Russians than the Congress.
Oh, so you think that if he vetoes it, it's because he wants something tougher than what they have in the sanctions bill?
He may sign the sanctions exactly the way they are. Or he may veto the sanctions and negotiate an even tougher deal against the Russians. He has a counterintuitive, counterpunching personality that, let me tell you, I was in Youngstown, Ohio with him. You cannot believe the fan base there. The American people get it. American people like what he's doing. The establishment does not like what he's doing. He's going to disrupt the establishment.
Why do you call the majority of America
to make it fair
the establishment?
For the American people?
Why do you call them that? Why do you? Because it's a disparaging thing. It's meant to be an insult. Why? Why insult the majority of the country?
Why insult the? I didn't hear the question. Say it again.
Why insult the majority of the country by calling them the establishment, like they're some type of other?
I'm not insulting the majority of the country.
The majority of the country.
You're really good with the verbal proofreading this morning. When I talk about
Anthony, I'm saying it because polls make it clear that the majority of America doesn't approve of the president right now. So when you say his critics, you're talking about the majority of the country.
Really,
I know he has
really
his fan base.
Micro-analyze polling inside the White House.
Look, I mean, we saw it in the general election. We saw it in the popular vote. We see it in every poll that comes out.
Let's talk about where the approval ratings are right now. When you microanalyze the approval ratings, there's aspects where the questions come in. I love the president, but I dislike XYZ. Or I love the president, I dislike XYZ. Once we start executing the president's agenda, and once we talk clearly and directly to the American people and get the American people to light up the Congress's switchboard to help us execute the president's agenda, that's the only way we're going to really be able to drain the
swamp.
But
isn't this leak investigation? Isn't the leak investigation a distraction from the agenda?
What's that?
Isn't a big part of this leak investigation a distraction from that agenda?
Oh, how is it a distraction? We have to clamp down the leaks. The president and I are working together with a large group of people now to suppress and clamp down the nefarious nature of these leaks. And again, I'm talking about the stuff going on with leaking on Syria, North Korea, and like I said, the president views the White House leaks, a lot of this stuff is small potatoes. I mean, I can't even have dinner with the guy. 7 minutes later, five journalists know that I'm having dinner with him, and they have the guest list. I don't know. Is that how we should be running the White House? You know we shouldn't be running the White House like that.
Look, I totally get why you want integrity of purpose within your White House. I think that your desire to be straight about it is important. I think that's why these tweets last night got you in a little bit of trouble, and I wanted to give you a chance to clarify it.
I'm not. Believe me, let me tell you something. I work for one person, okay? I report to the President of the United States. I talked to him 15 minutes this morning. I'm far from in trouble.
Okay, I'm not saying you're in trouble, but I'm saying the tweets
style,
and the deleting the tweets.
I have his full support, okay? Only thing he said to me is, if you're going on Chris Cuomo's show, you better be nice to you this morning. Otherwise, I'm not going to let you go on. But you're doing a good job so far.
But we both know.
Keep going. Do you have any other questions?
It's just not the job to be nice. It's to be fair. You know that, Anthony.
Okay. I'm using his words, and they're very playful. And so let me make sure that I'm getting the nuance to you. These are playful, jocular words.
I know. I just want everybody else to know.
When I say to Ryan Lizard, you're being unpatriotic, I understand and completely and totally respect.
Right.
Journalistic integrity.
I got it.
Like
now, let me ask you a
like
question that matters.
Podium, I wasn't a journalist, but I did play one on TV. And the journalists are figuring out whether they're on the left or on the right. I'm going to treat them with respect, dignity, and kindness because they're a member of the Fourth Estate. We all believe in the First Amendment. I'm going to give them the opportunity to review everything that we're doing.
I don't know any journalist who's trying to figure out if they're on the left or the right.
Clear transparency, Chris.
I don't know.